Hi, my name's Steve Ling and I'm from PC Paramedics. I'd like to show you how to configure a Netgear wireless router and connect it to the internet. For this, we're going to need a PC connected to the router via an Ethernet cable. And we're going to make our configuration simply by using a web browser. Some Netgear and other brands of routers come with a CD for configuration. Most people prefer to not use the CD and to simply use a web browser to configure the router the way you want. For that, we're going to open up a web browser such as Internet Explorer, and that's what I'm going to use today. Open up Internet Explorer, and in the address bar, we type in http://, and the dotted decimal address of the router, which is shown in your information here. In this particular case, the address is 192.168.0.1, and we hit return. That gives us a username and password, which has defaults, and you are able to change them as part of the configuration. But the default in the case of this particular Netgear is admin and password. Quite simple, and you can see why you would probably want to change them. Having entered those, you're now brought into a configurational screen. There is a simple setup wizard, which you can run through, but I prefer today to take you through setting the router up, configuring it manually. So the first thing we want to do is say no, we want to configure the router ourselves, and click next. In this particular box, it's asking if our internet connection requires a logon, as most do. So the answer is yes. The most common encapsulation used in the UK is PPOA. So we'll leave that setting, which is the default setting. And in here is where we're going to put the username and password that's been supplied by your internet service provider. So there is my username, and my password is quite a complicated one. If your internet service provider has provided you with a fixed IP address, this is the box in which you'll install it. So you put use fixed IP address and enter your fixed IP. In the majority of cases, you'll be assigned an IP address by your internet service provider, so you can leave the default setting as it is. The main name servers, again, as with the fixed IP address, you can automatically get your domain name servers from your ISP. Now we just simply click apply to save those settings, and we move on to the next part of the configuration, which in this case is going to be our wireless settings. Here, our site identification. It defaults to Netgear when you first buy it. You may wish to put something that's more easily recognized by you. An important part is to get the correct region area, because it changes the power output of your router. And it is in fact illegal to use USA when you are in fact in Europe. Here, an important feature is the channel number that the router is working on. Here it's defaulted to 11. There are 13 channels you can choose. And the reason you might want to change that is to get better range, better wireless performance around the property. But at the moment, we'll leave it on channel 11. And then you can change the mode in which the router operates: 54 megabytes, wireless B, wireless G, wireless G only, or you can put it into auto, which will give you up to 108 megabytes on this particular router. That's quite fast performance when you consider that most people don't have more than 24 megabytes of broadband bandwidth anyway. We need to tell the router that it's going to function as a wireless access point, and if you'd like that identification name to be broadcast so the whole world can see it, you can leave that ticked. Now, a very important thing is to put security on so that people can't use your broadband when they shouldn't be. A very common one would be to use WPA PSK. So we'll click on there, and that box will expand now to allow us to put in a pre-shared key. So there's my pre-shared key. You need to make a note of this, because any wireless device that wishes to access this router, from the time we click apply, will need to know that key. So we put in Fred Blogs 123, and we apply that, and it saves itself within the router. So basically now we are ready to go.